Hi, this is Imran. Welcome back to the new Troubleshooters channel once again. Today I'm going to show you how to configure an IPSec VPN in between Fortigate and Cyberoam firewalls. So, to establish a successful VPN connectivity, we need to ensure all of the authentication algorithm in phase 1 and phase 2. Should be same in both sides. Okay, then the secret key or the PSK key or certificates which will be used to authenticate IPSec connectivity between two sites must be same for both sides, otherwise the IPSec connection cannot be established between the sites. Okay, then we need to establish, we need to configure one or more specific routes to ensure the connectivity. Then, in Fortigate, we need to apply to inbound and outbound policy to ensure the connectivity through IPSec VPN. Okay. Now I'm going to configure IPSec VPN from Fortigate sites. Okay, in Fortigate we can configure IPSec VPN by using current VPN connection with creation wizard. Here, some predefined or system wizard. Here you can see we can easily configure IPSec VPN fit in between Fortigate to Fortigate, Fortigate to Cisco, and others. But in Fortigate, you can also have a custom, and you can also create configure a custom IPSec VPN in terms of others, in terms of others VPN for others vendors. Now I'm going to configure IPSec VPN with several. That's why I'm going to select custom. But we can also configure by using this wizard. After that, we can modify, we can customize the VPN configuration in terms of cyber. This is not the best practice, I think. Again, we should configure a custom VPN because we can see there is no predefined template to configure VPN connectivity between Cyberoam and Fortigate firewall. Okay, now we move on. I'm going to give a name, IPSec VPN host. Click the next. After that, here. Okay. To establish a VPN connection, we must name. We need to configure remote gateway and local gateway. This is must. Then we have to configure phase 1 authentication and phase 2 authentication, local networks and remote networks for communicating. Okay, here my remote gateway. Remote gateway would be for security reason, I am not going to tell you my public IP address. Then I am going to select the interface for which interface the VPN connectivity will be established. Then I am selecting my public ISP connectivity too. Then I am going to select the primary IP associated with this gateway. Okay. So my remote gateway, this one, and my local gateway, this one. Mode config, click on mode config. Net traversal shouldn't be needed. Dead period detection should be on demand. And the authentication or secret key. We can configure IPSec VPN connectivity by using a
signed certificate
in between two sites. We can also configure a VPN connectivity by using a secret key. This will be easy for everyone because we might not have any signed certification. They might need any extra subscription also, but it must be better if we can establish a signed certificate between two. Because we all know SSL certificates have more security, more reliability, and efficiency. Okay, this was good. In between IK version, IK protocol version, which is the main protocol version to for authentication in between to IPSec connectivity. IK version, I am selecting after configuring PSHET key. I am going to configure local and remote address or remote networks. So here my local address selecting a section 128 authentication SHA-256 then AES-192 authentication SHA-256 then 3DS authentication is 5. I'm removing the fourth one. I don't think this is needed. If I have one group, I'm using 5 or 14. You can also use 2, 100 and etc. Key life in second here. The key life in second, which is equal to 1 day. Okay. Then I'm already configured my local network and my zoom. Okay. Then I'm going to configure my phase 2 authentication, phase 2 proposal. So I'm in phase 2 authentication here. I'm going to configure AES 256, AES 256. To configure them, I need to remove that one. And first, AES 256, then I'm going to select SHA-256. I'm going to remove another one, and I'm going to add another one. Here, I'm going to select AES 192. Authentication is MD5. Then AES TES. Authentication is MD5. Message drive is required. Here, my default has been group the same as according to the phase 1. Okay. According to the phase 1. Now, just local port import autonomous here. Okay. Here, I'm going to make it the same. Same key life as well as the phase 1. According to the phase 1. Here. Here we go. So let's take a review. Here is the name, then this is the remote gateway, this is the local gateway, which is must be needed to establish a VPN connectivity. net traversal is enabled, but I'm going to do that. That is okay. I noticed one thing: if I disable the net traversal at initial configuration, then the phase in phase 2 selector and the local and remote gateway I can be put this value are hidden actually. That's why I'm configuring this one is first, then I'm configuring net traversal and phase 1 phase 2 authentication later. Okay, this tricks
should be
remind to configure this also. Okay, the net traversal disable, date peer detection on demand method, preset key, IPSec VPN method, preset key, and preset key is testing it that only has actually. And there's the phase one proposal and defilement group, TLS, authentication is disabled, authentication is disabled. Here's the local remote subnet, phase two authentication, and others. Sorry, okay.
Here's the
first part of VPN configuration. Then we need to configure an aesthetic routes through VPN. To create an aesthetic routes, we must go aesthetic routes, then click on create new. Then here we need to select the VPN interfaces or VPN channels which is configured already. Okay, here the destination should be selected as name service. From there we can select the remote subnet and we can configure the administrative distance as 10 because we have another IPSec VPN configuration with the same destination. That's why I'm going to I have to change the administrative distance. Okay, here we go. Here is the specific routes. Okay, then I have to configure two policy, two IP version 4 policy to ensure the VPN incoming and outgoing connectivity. So one policy should be IPSec 2 always using the name which is related to the policy, which also is to identify the purpose of each of the policy. That's why. So I'm going to select the IPSec interfaces, tunnel interfaces from as my incoming interface. Then I have to select my local interfaces as my outgoing interface. So the traffic comes from IPSec tunnel and in from IPSec tunnel out with my, to my local. Then the subnet, then the source should be all, destination should be selecting all. So destination in according to the interface and IP configuration, and source in according to the incoming interfaces. Okay, here I am selecting service all. I'm disabling NAT. I don't need any NAT. And I am
not
going to implement any secret policies initially. Okay.
But we can.
We can select some secret policies such as antivirus, smart key. It can be enabled or select. This is this. I'm selecting this. Then click on OK.
So
here is the policy. look at another IPSec policy. Here, my incoming would be a reverse. Okay, so also my incoming to my local vector and local interfaces. And my outgoing is IPSec is 2. Source all, destination all. Okay, service all. I'm also going to disable the match and I'm going to prevent the interference only. Okay, that's it. Okay. So we can see two policy already configured, but here we can see a yellow triangle because the tunnel not yet used. Because the other side need to be configured also. So let's go to the Cyberoam firewall. So in Cyberoam, we need to configure an IPSec authentication policy first, then we need to configure the IPSec VPN configuration. Okay. So that's why we need to configure an IPSec authentication policy here. Will be infinite. There is no boundary. Authentication mode is main mode. I'm not going to compress data because it is not supported by Fortigate. Okay, this one. In phase one, we have to configure the similar as like as Fortigate phase one. Okay, that's why. Here should be AES 48 and SHA-256, another one AES 192, SHA-256, then 3DS 25. Okay, defilement group is 5 and 40 as like as 48 phase 1, and key life is 6. Detection is enabled. This is, I'm going to leave this as default. There won't be any problem. So when and VPN connection connectivity cannot be established, what the policy will do? What action will do? I recommend that we need to select this reinitiate. This will reinitiate the overall process. Okay, then we are going to configure the phase two will be AES-256, SHA-256, then DS, then AES-192, then MD5, then another one is DS. Okay, and PFS, I mean defilement group has like this same as phase one, so the defilement group automatically selected by 5 or 14. Then key life recommend to configure the same as like as 40. Okay, here is the exact policy. Let's take a review on that. Okay. I think all is okay, so I'm going to click on OK. So here is the another policy name, Lavana. So that's why I need to rename this with 02. So I should be okay. Yeah, just done. Now I'm going to configure the IPSec VPN with Fortigate Navana. So I'm giving IPSec. Okay, here it is. And the connection types should be site to site. And policy. Policy should be IPSec with Navana
2,
which is configured.
It's even its
before. Okay. Action on VPN restart. Initiate. Bandwidth and interface. This is previous default. Here is the pressure key.
Pressure key should be must be.
It should be must be same on website.
That's right.
Same pressure key here. Okay, and here I'm going to select this one as my local gateway, and for my remote gateway I'm going to select the remote gateways. Here, then I have to add my local LAN, local, I mean local subnet. Yes, for other victim configuration, the local subnet wire configured. That's why I'm selecting this. I'm not going to native in between to the into this remote sites. That's why I'm leave it unlock. Okay. Then network shell is off and remote network here is colon and the remote network also set as like as 40kN, but from Cyberoam perspective the local should be the Cyberoam local and remote should be 40kN network should be its remote address. Okay, I'm already selecting this, then leave others as default. Okay, protocol all local port, remote port, should be all. I think there is this kind of trying to always try you. I need to connect actually. If all the configurations okay, then the VPN, IPSec VPN must be connected, must be established in between these two sites.
Here we go.
So now I am seeing, from several sites, the VPN connectivity in between two sites are established. Now, here we can see the remote network and local network are reachable through this VPN. So let's check from 48N. From 48, we need to go monitor and IPSec monitor. Okay, here we can see the IPSec channel is up. Okay. So now we can say that the IPSec VPN connection is successfully established in between two remote sites. So now we have to ensure our reachability, local to local reachability in between two sites. That's why I'm going to check here out. Look up here. Then it should be shows that we can reach over to this network through this channel. Okay, so we confirm that the VPN connectivity is established and we are able to reach the remote gateway through this tunnel, through this IPSec tunnel. From
Cyberoam, we can also check this.
Here we also have a lot of here I'm going to check.
Then we can see the remote network,
local network is traced through
this IP. This is my gateway IP of
the
VPN public interfaces, ISP interfaces actually. Okay, that's it.
I think I'm
successfully
show the VPN, IPSec VPN configuration and connectivity and the end results.
So that's it. Thank you for watching and don't forget to
subscribe my channel if you don't want to miss my upcoming videos, because I'm going to make
videos on
firewalls, on between Fortigate firewalls, Cyberoam firewalls and other networking devices and troubleshooters actually.
So that's it.